ladies and gentlemen, all distinguished guests. It's not a really good timing. Everybody busy with the coffee break and preparing for a very nice lunch. Before I start my presentation, so allow me to just sharing some short video that we won the competition in 2017 about how wonderful is Indonesia. Some exciting titles, the new way of Indonesian tourism. Let's start with this one. This is, I think, is very important. Where is the clickers? This is what we call it, the CEO commitment. I think all of us have the same understanding and belief that one of the most important is the CEO commitment. This is how that we said that if we talk about the Indonesian tourism, the sector of tourism compared to the previous, there is a commitment from our CEO, President Jokowi. He said that I declare tourism as the leading sector. Tourism as a leading sector is the good news. And all other ministry must support the tourism's development. This is, I think, is very important. Why? Because of when we talk about the government, let's say compared to private sectors, sometimes it's very difficult for us, quote unquote, to get the fully support from the government because of the coordinations problems, communications problems, not enough focus, not enough commitment. So how that we want to answer all this issue with this one, the CEO commitment, the commitment from our presidents, especially now when we talk that everybody know after the April elections that President Jokowi is already won for the second term from 2019-2024. That I think this is gives some more confidence to all of us. He said in his Indonesian Vision speech in July 14, 2019, first, we will continue to build infrastructures. This is, I think, is very important for Indonesia. If we talk about the ecosystem of the tourism, we always said about the 3A philosophy. The first one is attractions. If we talk about Indonesia, if we talk about the attraction of Indonesia, I think nobody doubt about the attraction of tourism of Indonesia. Indonesia is one of the most diversified countries in the world. We have more than 17,000 islands. We have more than 800 ethnics from the culture's point of view, from the nature's point of view. I think we are one of the most diversified countries in the world. So from the first A, philosophy of the ecosystem of the tourism, the attraction one, I think nobody doubt about the Indonesian, the potential, etc., etc. Now we move to the second A, accessibility. This is one of our biggest problems. When we talk about the accessibility of Indonesia, especially we go back to 5 years ago, we talk about the Jakarta airport. It's always a jam because of it's already more than 100% capacity. If we talk about the Yogyakarta airport, designed for 1.7 million, now is already 7 million passengers a year, more than 5 times over the original capacity. If we talk about the Ngurah Rai airport, there is a queuing for airlines to have a new slot. It's already 35 flights per hour, maximums. Or we have to build the new airport, build the new runway like Jakarta airport, or for Yogyakarta, for example, we built the new airport. And thanks God, it's just finished 2 months ago for the first stage, and hopefully we'll be finished totally mid next year. So why that President Jokowi said that infrastructure is very important. And he already said that we have built a large infrastructure. Going forward, we will proceed more quickly and connect the large infrastructures such as toll roads, transport and airport, with the people production area. We connect with small industrial zone, connect with special economic zone, and of course, connect with the tourism area. This is, I think, just some short summary why the tourism as the core economy of Indonesia. So why that there is a full commitment from our presidents. Number one, tourism is the largest contributor to foreign exchange earning. This is that we try to learn from Thailand, how that the tourism make a very good example and benefit for the country. Number two, we are best in regions. This is to make sure that we are goes on the right track. Just 2 months ago, S&P raised our Indonesian sovereign credit rating from BBB-, the lowest in the investment grade, to the BBB+, with the positive outlook. This means that in the next 5 years from now, the outlook for Indonesia is really positive and is already one notch above the investment grade. Country branding, Wonderful Indonesia. We make a very serious effort to make branding of Wonderful Indonesia is on the top line. We hiring all the best consultant in the world. We are hiring the best PR consultant in the world to helping us to make the branding of Wonderful Indonesia is already on the top line. This is our outline today. I have another 10 minutes before goes to the Q&A session. The first one, Indonesian tourism performance, just to show you that we are goes on the right track. to give you more confidence level for Indonesian tourism sectors. Number two is our formulation and implementation strategy. And last but not least, government support and investment opportunity in the developing tourism sector, especially for 10 priority tourism destinations, or we know as the 10 New Bali. Let's start with the first framework, the Indonesia TTCI World Economic Forum performance that we grow positively from 2008 to 2017. You can see that in 2008, we are number 80. And in 2017, we jump into number 42. This is how that the President Jokowi, all the ministry, they bring all the professional, like myself. I have more than 30 years background in the private sectors, to helping the governments to transform from the business as usual government into a government that really support the private sectors, really support the business sectors. You can see this one, how we jump our travel and tourism competitive index. And we're still working very hard. We are not like the first presentation said that fear it's okay, but complacently make you die. We are happy with 42, but still, we still want to working very hard to improve our competitive index. This is more details. The red one is our bottom three, and the blue one is our top three. We're working very hard to always improve our competitive index. This is our performance in the last 3 years. We are number 9 fastest tourism group in the world, number 3 in Asia, and number 1 in Southeast Asia. This is all the details. Sorry that I have to make faster because of somebody on the back remind me about another just only 10-minute presentation. This is to see how the Indonesian tourism increase in success. Yeah. This is our foreign tourism growth. Yeah, you can see that in 2009 till 2013, our CAGR is 9%. But during the President Jokowi era, we make it almost double, jump from 9% to 14%. This is our performance. In 2019, in 2016, 17, 18, and 19, so many awards from so many countries. Now we go to the formulation and the execution of the implementation and the strategy. Now we are very, very focused compared to before. Before, so many things that we want to do, but nothing happened. Now we are very focused with what that we call it, the top 10 priority program of the Ministry of Tourism that we working together with all ministry. Number one is digital tourism. I think everybody in this room is agree. 63% of all travel is now reached, booked, and paid through the online, through their gadget. 50% of online travel sales involve more than one device. And especially if you talk about Indonesia, more than 50% of the population of Indonesia is the millennial. Indonesia is the country with almost the youngest average age in the world. The average age of the Indonesian people is 28 years old. So you can imagine the potential of Indonesia in the future, especially if we talk about the leisure business, if we talk about the tourism business. This is our top 10 program. Number one is digital tourism. Number two, homestay and tourism village. Number three, air accessibility. We push very hard to improve our accessibility in the last 5 years. Branding and PRing, we know that, so why that we hiring the best PR consultant in the world to make our wonderful Indonesia branding is the top notch. Top 10 origination, we are very focused with our target market. Top three main destination, at the moment we are talk about Bali. Bali contribute 50% of the total origination of Indonesia. And then Jakarta is contribute around 40%. And then Rio Island is 10%. Yeah, so why that I agree with you, Raj, that we have to create the new product. We have to create the new destination. So why that we come up with the 10 New Bali? And then we talk about the certified human resources in tourism and tourism awareness movement. I think John already mentions that under the Minister of Tourism today, we have 6 universities, like NHI Bandung, like Sekolah Tinggi Pariwisata Bali, We have Lombok, we have Makassar, and we working together with more than 100 university. And then the tourism investment growth, I already mentioned to you that S&P raised our rating, and then the crisis center management. This is very important. For example, how that we recover from the Mount Agung eruption, because of there is so many hoax. So now, if you go to our office, we have a war room like Iron Man office. It's a totally fully digital. We monitoring all digitals online, real time, what's going on the social media. They are talk about Indonesia. So our crisis center management is working 24/7 to monitoring everything's happen about us, everything happen about our competitor. This is all dimensions to you about the ecosystem of tourism. We talk about 3A philosophy: attraction, accessibility, amenity, the portfolio, the government leading, especially for accessibility. And if we talk about the amenity, I think it's all your job of to the private sector lending. This is the pentahelix. I want to speed up the government support. Yeah. We make all the deregulations to make Indonesia is the best climate for investment. We try to learn from Thailand. We try to learn from Malaysia. We try to learn from other country. This is, I think, the best, what that we call it, leadership from our president, from our minister. He always said, why that this is can happen in Malaysia, why this is can happen in Thailand, but cannot happen in Indonesia? What's going on with us? We have to make some significant improvement to improve our competitiveness. This is our visa free. So you can see, we jump from just only 15 countries to 169 countries in 2019 for visa free visa arrival, simplifying yacht arrival. I just went back from C-Trade Miami last year. They all said that in the next 10 years, Southeast Asia, especially Indonesia, will be a very important destination for marine tourism. So they are not only talk Mediterranean, Caribbean, but now they start to talking about Southeast Asia, especially Indonesia. Raja Ampat, Labuan Bajo, Sabang, Anambas Island, all the destination of marine tourism. This is I show you about the foreign and domestic direct investment. You can see our CIGR, we jump from 15% to 25%. And especially for the second term of President Jokowi, because we almost finished with most of our homework, especially number one, infrastructure and accessibility. We already finished with the new Yogyakarta Airport. We already finished with the Silangit Airport. We already finished the new toll road from Medan Kuala Namu to Lake Toba. We almost finished with the toll road from Semarang to Yogyakarta. So we really confident for the second term of the President Jokowi that we can maintain our CAGR at least 25%, hopefully more than 25%. This is the determination of the 10 priority tourism destination by Mr. President. He lead directly, he lead day by day. Every 3 months, he goes to the top 4 destination. Every 3 months, he goes to Borobudur. Every 3 months, he goes to Lake Toba. Every 3 months, he go to Labuan Bajo, just to make sure that everything is goes on track. This is the tourism Indonesian centric that already mentions to you about Tanyu Bali. You know, from west to east, we start from Lake Toba, and then Belitung, and then Tanjung Lesung, Bromo Tengger Seru, Mandalika, last but not least, Morotai. The red star means the top priority. This is our progress of Tanyu Bali, especially from the infrastructure support point of view. We still above the target. Yeah. Lake Toba, you can see how beautiful Lake Toba. Yeah. This is the monthly meeting with our presidents. Lake Toba investment plan, at the moment is already 7 investor with the total amount of 6.1 trillion rupiah to invest in Lake Toba. We signed last year in during the World Bank IMF annual meeting. This is the Borobudur, yeah, the world-class cultural masterpiece. We almost finished with the ITMP, Integrated Tourism Master Plan. Mandalika, Ibu Shirley, thank you that make my job is more easier. Pak Budi juga, thanks that make my job more easier. The investment opportunity, with the status of special economic zones of Mandalika, Yeah, you can get some not only support from the infrastructure point of view, but you can get fully support from the tax incentive, fiscal incentive. Yeah. Labuan Bajo. Yeah, this is last month. You can see myself on the left, my Mr. President. Yeah. This is the expansion opportunity, the magnificent tourist attraction. We almost finished too, hopefully before end of this year with the ITMP for the Labuan Bajo Flores. For sure, we talk about the ecotourism. For sure, we talk about the sustainability tourism development philosophy. Yeah. Last but not least, before it goes to the Q&A session, this is, I think, the summary of three reasons to invest in Indonesian tourism sector. Number one, again, Raj already gave a very good statement that we are the world's fourth largest population and demographic bonus. Yeah. More than 65% of our population at the productive age until 2050. Indonesian average age is 28 years old. Economic growth potential. In the last 5 years, we can maintain our economic growth more than 5%, driven by strong consumer confidence. And then high investment incentive, already mentioned to you that there is a fully support from our government about the tax incentive. And then especially today, after finish with the election, that a supportive political from the new government, hopefully after the October. And then high investment grade, yeah. I already mentioned to you that 2 months ago, S&P already raised our Indonesian sovereign credit ratings from BBB- to BBB. Yeah. And then, of course, the massive infrastructure development, which include the tourism area. I think just this is my short presentation. Of course, 15 minutes is not enough to share what that we already did in the last 5 years and what we want to do in the next 5 years during the second term of President Jokowi. Thank you to sharing this all information. So it have another 1 minute for Q&A. If there is a question, what's all is already very clear. Everybody convincing to put their investment. Oh yeah. Okay. Let's start with the first question from Robert Harp. Do you think there is a demand for a theme park like Disneyland Indonesia? For sure, yes. If we talk about some theme park in Singapore or Malaysia, you go there, I go there, I go to Legoland, I go to Universal Studio, you can see that maybe the visitor is more than 50% came from Indonesia. You go to the music concert in Singapore, Coldplay, you name it, more than 50% visitors came from Indonesia. I tried to initiate almost 15 years ago for a Disney Mountain, the first and the only Disney Mountain at that time in Lido, West Java. But because of internal issue, we are not continuing the process. But yes, I think Indonesia, especially when we reflect to World Bank study, that if some country already passed $4,000 income per capita, now Indonesia in the situation of $4,500 income per capita. So every 5 years, their income per capita will be double until $15,000 when they will meet what that we call it the middle income country trap, when they are not make some enough investment in HR and innovation. So for Indonesia, in the next 5 or even 10 years from now, the purchasing power, the buying power, I believe will be more double than today. If you go to Jakarta now, if you go to, I don't know, you go to the Jatim Park in East Java, yeah, during the weekend is jam. Hotel occupancy, Jatim Park, 90%. The average occupancy rate, occupancy rate is more than 90%. Because of the domestic market is very, very strong. Talk with the Archipelago, talk with the Accor, check the three-star hotel performance. It's very strong because of the domestic market is very strong. So I agree with the question about the, there is a possibility in the future to make a world-class theme park in Indonesia. Yeah. Specifically when they have some, like Pak Budi Tirtawinata said, some unique preposition to make some differentiation compared to Universal Studios Singapore, to make some differentiation compared to Legoland Malaysia. Any solid update on the development of North Bali? It's already decided by our government, but because of the April election, on hold. But maybe early next year, we start again to speed up the process. Because of, I already mentioned to you, the capacity of Ngurah Rai Airport now is already 35 flights per hour. No more capacity. Yeah. I know very well a lot of airlines, they want more slots to landing and take off in Ngurah Rai Bali, but we don't have enough capacity. So the only answer is build a new runway, but it's very difficult because of we have to do the reclaim, and it's not easy at the moment, or build North Bali Airport. Yeah. Last question, any solid update on the development of North Bali? Not yet, because of, you have to know, I think, that there is a new governor here in Bali. Yeah. April this year. But the good things of this new governor, that he's really support the environmental sustainability. He already released a new regulations to ban the plastic bag. He already released the new regulations to ban the plastic straw. Because of, we are really need a regulation, especially the new regulation with the situation of environmental friendly. But same thing happened with the North Bali Airport. We believe that early next year, we will start to speed up the development of North Bali. And please remember, North Bali is not far from Banyuwangi. Banyuwangi now is already is a very fast growing destination. If you go there, the Alila Group just opened their new hotel there end of last year. And it's already so many hotel there because of a good spirit of the chief of the local government. He not allowed to open the budget hotel there. Just only 3-star, 4-star, and 5-star or homestay. And he really did the calculation of the carrying capacity, not just release the new permit for the new hotels. When the occupancy rate is already 50 to 60%, and then release the new permits. So he want to maintain the investors' expectation. Yeah. Okay? That's, I have to be frank with you that one of the biggest issue for Bali because of before, very easy to release new permit for build a new hotels without do some detailed calculations about the carrying capacity. The capacity of the new hotel is big, but not enough infrastructure, especially airport. So why that? That's the biggest problem of Bali. Because of we don't have enough new slot of airports. We already in 35 flights per hour for Ngurah Rai Airport, yeah, maximums. The best in the world is Heathrow Airport, 55 flights per hour because of the design of the airport, and number two is the technology. Indonesia, 35 maximum. Jakarta Airport and Bali Airport. Okay, I think now it's already 12 o'clock. Thank you for the opportunity, especially to Mr. Manaf. Hopefully, I can give you some insight, more confidence level about Indonesia. Yeah. Please contact me. Yeah. I don't know, but my email is very easy, Hiramsyah, my first name, @yahoo.com, so you can email me at any time. Yeah, because I have to work 24/7 to helping you. Yeah, to make our investment bigger and bigger and bigger. Again, thank you. Good afternoon, all of you.